Hi students, we move on to the second part of the lesson, Reach for the Top. It's on Maria Sharapova. Before we move on to the lesson, did you see the box, the match of the following? We'll just say the meanings of that. It will make it easier. Something disarming. What is the answer that matches with that? Something that makes you feel friendly. Taking away your suspiciousness. At odds with, in contrast to, or not agreeing with. Glamorous attire, attractive and exciting clothes. In almost no time, means quickly, almost immediately. Then poised beyond her years. More calm, confident and in control than people of her age usually are. Packed off, send off. Launched, started. And heart-wrenching, causing strong feelings of sadness. So you mark it and keep. As we read, this will help you. There is something disarming about Maria Sharapova. Something at odds with a ready smile and glamorous attire. So disarming means something that makes you feel friendly. And at odds with her ready smile and glamorous attire, which does not match with her. There is something in her that which does not match with her smile and glamorous attire. And that something in her lifted her on Monday, 22nd August 2005, to the world number one position in women's tennis. All this happened in almost no time. In almost no time means very quickly. Poised beyond her years. Poised means calm and composed. The Siberian-born teenager took just 4 years as a professional to reach the pinnacle. Pinnacle means the highest point. However, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world began 9 years before with a level of sacrifice few children would be prepared to endure. Endure means bear. Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in the United States. That trip to Florida with her father, Yuri, launched her on the path to success and stardom. But it also required a heart-wrenching 2-year separation from her mother, Yelena. The latter was compelled to stay back in Siberia because of visa restrictions. The 9-year-old girl had already learned an important lesson in life, that tennis excellence would only come at a price. That is, she has to sacrifice something for that. That is what it means. It's not that easy. I used to be so lonely, Maria Sharapova recalls. I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going, so he couldn't see me either. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. The other tennis pupils would come in at 11 p.m. and wake me up and order me to tidy up the room and clean it. She is the youngest. No, naturally, the others can boss over her. Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted. Underline. When you come from nothing and you have nothing, then it makes you very hungry and determined. I would have put up with much more humiliation and insults than that to steadfastly pursue my dream. So she didn't mind all that. She says that she was ready to endure worse humiliations than that to pursue her dream. Pursue means follow. Steadfastly means firmly. That toughness runs through Maria even today. It was the key to her backing the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004 and to her meteoric rise to the world number one spot the following year. Meteoric means like a meteor. While her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis has touched the hearts of tennis fans, for the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. The straight looks and the answers she gives when asked about her ambition make it amply clear that she considers the sacrifices were worth it. I am very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job. This is her mantra for success. Though Maria Sharapova speaks with a pronounced American accent, she proudly parades her Russian nationality. Clearing all doubts, she says, I am Russian. It is true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian. I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me. Like any number of teenage sensations, Maria Sharapova lists fashion, singing and dancing as her hobbies. She loves reading the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. The author of the famous series Sherlock Holmes. Her fondness for sophisticated evening gowns appears at odds with her love of pancakes with chocolate spread and fizzy orange drinks. Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. Pigeonholed means assigned to a particular category. It's very difficult to limit her talent like that. Her talent, unwavering desire to succeed, and readiness to sacrifice have lifted her to the top of the world. So in her case, these are the three things. Her talent, unwavering means not fluctuating, desire to succeed, and the readiness to sacrifice. Few would grudge her the riches she is now reaping. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. Of course, money is a motivation. Tennis is a business and a sport. But the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That is the dream that kept me going. And that is not money. It's that competitive spirit. I want to be the number one in the world of tennis. That kept me going. Okay, that's all. Hope you understood the lesson. Thank you, children.